The US dollar continues to lose ground after a series of statements by Fed officials that clarified the dovish rhetoric. Financial markets are expecting an interest rate cut in the coming months. Meanwhile, investors are closely watching the upcoming macroeconomic reports from the United States to assess the prospects for the start of a monetary easing. The expectation is that the rate will be lowered from March next year. In our review, we will talk about events that may affect investor sentiment this week. However, the economic calendar has a lot of publications to offer, not only from the United States. On Thursday, investors will continue to assess the prospects for the global economy. China will publish the manufacturing PMI for November, reflecting the economic activity of the country's largest and the most important industrial enterprises. According to forecast, the downward trend will continue and the recovery remains fragile. The news may revive the demand for the safe haven assets and put pressure on the Australian dollar. Notably, the Australian dollar is not only a barometer of risk in the Asia-Pacific trading session, but also the currency of the country that supplies commodities to the Chinese industry. So any negative views about the Chinese economy weakens the Australian dollar. The European Union Consumer Price Index will also be released on Tuesday. This indicator is closely watched by investors, as the head of the European Central Bank recently announced the signs of an acceleration in price growth, forcing the European Central Bank to prepare for another rate hike. However, as we can see from the forecast, whether the data is inaccurate or the ECB head is wrong. If the forecast of a slowdown in the inflation rate is confirmed, the market may start selling the euro. Currently, the single currency is overbought and needs a correction. Canada will report on the GDP growth rate of its economy in September. After a period of stagnation, GDP is expected to increase slightly. And most likely, the Canadian currency will be more influenced by the OPEC Plus energy deal outcomes. If it's decided to extend the oil supply cut, the Canadian dollar may revive support. Otherwise, the Canadian currency will likely sag against its US counterpart. Meanwhile, the US dollar is unlikely to have enough strength for growth. On Thursday, there will be some important information on the state of consumer spending, one of the key indicators for the US economy. Forecasts are disappointing, and US consumer spending is expected to inch up by a modest 0.2% in October, which is unlikely to impress investors. Risk appetite is unlikely to improve on Friday. Markets expects will report on the Chinese industry, assessing the activity of medium and small companies. Notably, large companies failed to recover in November, so it's unlikely that the small ones will succeed. At the end of the week, investors will return to the Canadian dollar, whose investment appeal will be evaluated based on the employment change report. In addition, investors will assess the US manufacturing activity. The ISM manufacturing PMI below the 50-point threshold points to an impending recession in the manufacturing sector of the US economy. The only real solution is the need to reduce interest rates to support businesses. Against this backdrop, the US dollar will likely continue to decline. And we will monitor the market reaction to the above-mentioned reports. Subscribe to our channel and follow changes in market sentiment with us. Any comments, questions, and offers are welcomed. We wish you profitable trading and see you soon.